Over the last little while, I've been using Facebook audio clips to connect with my prospects in Facebook Messenger, and it has been working very well. Now, in my opinion, the reason why it's working really well is it adds a personal touch, and my prospects are absolutely loving this strategy, and it makes you look like a rock star. It is literally one of my favorite new prospecting tools. However, I believe that there is a right way to use these Facebook audio clips, and then there's a wrong way to use them that might turn off people, at least certain people. So I want to share with you in this video what I'm actually specifically doing using the Facebook voice audio recorder in my Messenger to connect with prospects that has been working really well. And you can copy this strategy and use it in your business with your team as much as you like. My name is Tanya Aliza, and I help entrepreneurs and network marketers create success fast while most importantly designing a lifestyle that you love. So if you're new here, consider subscribing because I put out a brand new training episode and free resource for you and your business each and every week. Now, there are a couple of reasons that you must consider in using this tool as a prospecting tool for you and your team and your business when connecting with people using social media. Number one, it adds a awesome personal touch in your connection in kind of a cold, cold world. I mean, social media, if you think about it, when you're connecting with people, it's kind of a cold connection. So this adds a warm connection to the process that people are absolutely loving if you do it right. It makes you definitely stand out from the crowd, and it catches their attention. So number one, you have to know how to use the Facebook audio voice recorder in Messenger. And so what I want to do is I want to share with you how to use it really quickly, and then I want to show you how I'm using it in my business so that you can copy the same process. And now, I just want to leave a caveat for you. When I teach you how to use this tool, Facebook and technology changes from time to time. So if these steps are not completely looking the same when you are watching this video and you're trying to figure it out, just very simply go to your friend Google or YouTube and type in and find a little tutorial on how to use the Facebook voice audio clip in Messenger if these steps aren't exactly the same when you're watching this video. Gotta love technology, it's always changing on us. Now there's two ways that you can use this voice audio message clipper. I think I'm saying that right. Voice audio clip, all right? So instead of using like text message to connect with people, you can use you can send them a little voice message, almost like you can now do with text messages. And so they can hear your voice, they can hear your inflections in your voice, they can, you know, they can build a better relationship with you, I believe. This is why people are really liking it when I'm leaving voicemails. So you can do it on mobile, and you can also do it on desktop, so whatever you're using at the time. So if you're on mobile, you want to make sure that you download the Facebook Messenger app. Okay, you can do it from the Messenger app. So once you have that downloaded on your phone and installed, this now shows all of just your messages that you're getting on Facebook. And so this is for your personal profile. The Messenger is connected to your personal profile. And so you download the app, and then when you go into one of these messages, you can actually click the arrow on the left until you see a little microphone icon. And then what you want to do is hold that down and speak. And then once you let it go, it will send. Now on desktop, you can log into your Facebook, go to the messages, and click the See All Messages in Messenger. You have to be in Messenger to access this feature, so that's why you want to do that. But once you're in Messenger, you can go to any message or contact, click the microphone icon, click record to record, and then click the record button again for it to stop and send. So now that you know how to send a Facebook audio clip in Messenger, either using the app or on desktop, I'm going to walk you through specifically how I'm using it and some of the things that I'm saying, some of the scripts that I'm using when I connect with a prospect that's actually getting a very good reaction from my prospect and actually getting people to, you know, interact back with me and get people excited about what it is that I want to talk to them about when it comes to my product, service, or business. So you got to understand the phases of prospecting. This is really important. There's not just like one thing that you do. There's different phases when it comes to prospecting. So the first phase is the initial connection. So let's say you have a list of people on your Facebook or your social media that you want to connect with because you want to start the conversation. You've never talked to them about your business or products before. You just want to start that conversation. So what I would do is I would hold down the voice recorder and I would just start the conversation. And I don't ever tell them too much. The only goal of phase one is to get them connecting back with you. This is really important. So I might, you know, hold the voice recorder down and I'll be like, you know, hey John, what's going on? Tanya here, happy new year. Okay. So it depends on what time of the year it is or whatever, but just get the conversation started. That's the only initial goal of that connection. You know, hey, what's up? What are you doing? What have you been working on lately? Just wanted to connect with you and say hi here. Okay, so it would just be to get the connection started. You want them you want to get them to get interacting back with you. The second phase of that connection is to see if they're open. Okay, so you don't want to go through any crazy small talk or, you know, try to find out too much before you don't present. I just get right to the point. And so what I would say on the initial or the second connection, the second phase is once they react back to you, okay, this is the only time that you'll go into phase two is if phase one is completed and they've connected back with you. They say something like, hey, nice to hear from you. Oh, wow, this is a cool voice message that you left. People are always blown away by that because not a lot of people are using the voice clip audio. So they really like, they're interested. They're like, oh my goodness, this is kind of cool, right? Because they're always used to getting these text messages back. So the second phase, I would say, I would get right into it and I would say, you know, here's exactly why I'm connecting. And there's a 3-message text script that works really, really well if you want to connect with people and kind of work through the phases and, you know, work through the psychology of what gets people to, you know, get interested in what you're talking about that I've designed that works really well. And so I'm going to leave that as a resource for you in this episode over on the blog for you if you want to pick up these exact scripts and modify them and make them your own. So you can actually go get my social media scripts that convert and then you can apply it to when you're leaving your voicemails in these phases. You can pick that up on my blog at tanyaaliza.com/98download, the number 98 download. And that'll take you to my blog post right underneath this video. There'll be a big yellow button. And if you click that button, you can request free access to my 3-message text script. And you can just convert that into audio when you leave these audio clips. And I think that would really help you. Just remember with anything like scripts or anything, make them your own. Put your own personality, of course, to the scripts. So just to give you an example on what that would look like, you know, I'd hold the voice message down and I would be like, John, that's really cool. You know, whatever he replied back, I'd react to that in some way. I'd be like, hey, listen, you know, your name popped up on Facebook and I know that you live out in the Chicago area and I'm actually working on a really exciting project. And I immediately thought of you because you were out in the Chicago area. Do you at all keep your options open when it comes to other side projects if it didn't interfere with what you're already doing? I'd love to connect with you more and share with you what has gotten me all excited in this new year or like whatever time of the year it is or whatever, you know, just modify it a little bit based on when you're connecting and why you're connecting. All right, so that would be the second phase is you wanna ask if they are open. The third phase is only really going to transpire if John gets back to you or your prospect gets back to you and says, yes, like, tell me more. What has got you all excited? Yes, I am open. And so you want a yes at this point. If they say, no, I'm not open, then just go, okay, great, John. It was awesome connecting. I'm excited to, you know, see more of your Facebook posts. Have an awesome day. But if they say yes, like, tell me more, what does that look like? Then you're going to move into phase 3 of the prospecting, you know, process using the voice audio clip, which is kind of cool. It adds a more personal connection, right? So you're going to move into phase 3 and then your phase 3 is give them the next step. Okay, so tell them how you're going to get the information in front of them. And this is going to be different for every network marketing team that exists out there. You have your way that your team has proven to work as far as presenting goes. Use that process and just let them know how you're going to take them through those steps. So for me, inside of my team, we've got a Facebook group that we pop people into, and there's all the information in there, and it's this really exciting group. There's lots of social proof and excitement going on there. So I'm gonna say something like this. I'll be like, okay, John, that's awesome. You're keeping your options open, or you're open to a side project. I'm really excited about this, and I can get some more information in front of you. There's a Facebook group that I have here that will explain all the details of this side project that I'm working on, and I can pop you into that Facebook group. And if you can just do me a favor before I do that, what does your schedule look like? It'll probably take you about 30 or 40 minutes to go through that information and gather all the information and write down any questions that you have. And then I'd like to circle back around with you and answer any of your questions and collect your feedback and see if you see an opportunity for yourself. So based on your schedule, it'll take you about 30, 40 minutes. How soon do you think you can carve out the time to get that information? So you can see part of the process in step three that I do, or phase three, is not only like letting them know what the next step is, but before I even take them into that next step, I confirm with them when they will be able to view the information. So whatever it is for you, if you have a website that you're sending to people, or a video of some sort, or wherever you're sending them, or whatever you're sharing with them, make sure that you confirm a time and you never just send out your information blindly and then let them now have control over the marketing process. You always want to be telling people how to move through the steps with you. And that is the biggest like leadership tip that I can share with you that will help you with your process. And then phase number four is just, you know, take them through the presentation, however that is with you. So then you'll just, you know, confirm that you've added them to the group. So once John gets back to me in that text thread or in that voice thread, maybe he starts using, the voice recorder too, and then now becomes really fun. What he's going to say, or what your prospect is going to say, is, you know, I can look at it tonight, or I can look at it tomorrow, whatever they come back with you to you by. And then I'll just say, okay, great. Here's what I'm going to do. I've just added you to our Facebook group. It's called this. And I've tagged you in the pinned post, or I've just go into that group, or whatever your process is. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to circle back around later today, probably around 4 o'clock, and I'll meet you back in here in Messenger, and I will answer any questions that you have and get some feedback from you and ask you if you do see an opportunity for yourself on this side project that I'm really excited about. So enjoy the videos, or enjoy the group, whatever it is, right? So the four phases, guys, really, really, really important. But what I'm doing is I'm literally walking people through the entire process via the Facebook Messenger, leaving them voice scripts. Now, what this does is a couple of things. It's going to build a better process for you, walking them through that information right from the get-go. It's going to add a huge personal touch to it. But what it's mainly going to do, this is the hugest thing that I've noticed in my team, is it's mainly going to also leave them with a thread on how I presented with them, so that they can study that if they get started with me, that they can go back to that conversation and see how I did it, so that they can model that same exact process in their prospecting when they start with me and they want to go through those same steps. It's an incredible strategy that is all documented in the thread inside of Facebook Messenger. So it is so, so powerful for you and your team to learn this prospecting tool and use it in your business. Now, I'm going to leave you with a couple of powerful tips, because if you use the voice recorder properly and leave these audio clips properly, you're going to see a lot of results. It's going to be very exciting for you and your team. But if you don't use it properly, you're not going to see the same results. So here's a couple of things that I've learned along the way, doing it many times already in my business. Number one is, if you're dealing with somebody that's super busy, or a business owner, or an influencer, if you're prospecting that type of a person, leaving long-winded voicemails for them or voice clips for them is not going to be a turn on, it's going to be a turn off. So you may want to mix it up if you're talking to an influencer, and maybe just start with a video or an audio clip, and then just keep it short and sweet. And then you might mix it up in transition and using a little bit of text and then a little bit of audio. So you don't want to be too long-winded if you're talking to somebody that's super busy, moving and shaking, if that's the type of person that you're prospecting. Tip number two, voice inflections are really, really important when you use your voice clip recorder, okay? So act excited by about 5% more than what your normal excitement is, okay? So be you, don't be a crazy person, don't be like, oh my gosh, I'm so excited about this thing, you know? And if that's not really you, it's just gonna look weird, okay? But it's important to use the right voice inflections when you're dealing with people. And some people are well-versed in studying in voice inflections and some people are not. A book that I would highly recommend if you want to get good at voice inflections and being able to inspire and empower people through voice or even video is to pick up The Power of Voice Inflection by Zig Ziglar. It's a really good book and I'll leave it in the resource section of this video below in the description box or in the show notes for you, and you can check that training out. It's a really, really good book, The Power of Voice Inflection. And to help you with these phases and to make sure that I don't leave you hanging at all, I've put together the scripts that I just went over in this video in more detail for you in the freebie that goes with this episode. And it's my Facebook voice clip scripts that you can use when you're out prospecting. I've put those together for you over on the blog at tanyaaliza.com/98. Download. Make sure you pick that up. If you like them, share them with your team and get everybody doing these voice clip audios because they're really, really powerful. Question of the week. Are you using Facebook voice clip audios already using on Facebook with your prospects at all? If you are, I want to know what you love most about it. Drop me a comment below. I'd love to know. Did you get value out of today's episode of Tanya Aliza TV? I sure hope that you did. If you did get value and you think that this information can help anybody else in your world or your team, make sure to click the share button below, above, or around this video. Get this video out there, and I'll be sure to see you on the next episode of Tanya Aliza TV. Hey Tanya, I just wanted to let you know that you absolutely crushed this week's episode of Tanya Aliza TV. Hey, it is totally okay to leave messages for yourself on Facebook as well. Keep your messages on Facebook fun, guys. Have fun with this voice clip recorder. What do you actually call this thing? Is it voice clip, Facebook voice clip recorder? Facebook voice clip recorder. I'm gonna Google that. Is it a Facebook voice message clip recorder? With voice message, Facebook message voice clip recorder. I said it wrong like 50 times in the video. I have no idea. It's just voice clips on Facebook. Just leave a voicemail for people on Facebook. Voice message, voice text message? Voice clip, recorder, message, voice clip, voice clips, or voice message just on Facebook. Just leave a voice message on Facebook for your people.